Okay, good morning to one and all. So in today's session, we will discuss 3D object representation methods. So there are many methods related to 3D object representation. So we'll discuss one by one the methods of 3D object representation. Now, what is meant by 3D object representation, or what are different, why there are different 3D object representation methods? First of all, in the world, there are different objects. Okay, those objects like trees, mountains, home, human hair, geometrical shapes, clouds, vehicles, etc. So all those particular objects are different in shape, different in size. And because of that, all objects cannot be described by one single representation, right? So that here we know that trees, mountains, home, human hair, geometrical shapes, clouds, everything is having a different shape. If you are taking a tree, so tree will be like this. Then if you are taking a mountains, so mountains will be something like this. Home you are taking, then home will be something like this, right? Then if you take clouds, so clouds will be in any shape, means like amoeba. There are vehicles, so every object are having a different shapes, and because of that, a single method cannot be used to represent the object. Hence there are different methods of 3D object representation. Now you must understand why there is a need of different methods. So first reason is, in the world there are multiple objects, and all objects are different in shape, different in size. Hence the all objects cannot be described by one method, and because of that, there are multiple 3D object representation methods. So which are the 3D object representation methods? We have list of methods. So first method of 3D object representation, that is nothing but polygon tables. So we'll discuss in detail what is meant by polygon tables. Then second method of 3D object representation, that is polygon equations. Then we'll discuss the next method is sweep representation. We have one more method as a constructive solid geometry, that is also called as CSG. Constructive solid geometry are also called as CSG. We have a quad tree, we have octree, and we have fractals as well. So those many methods are used. Those are some methods enlisted here can be used for representing a 3D object. Now the first method, we'll begin with the first method of 3D object representation, that is nothing but polygon tables. So in case of polygon tables, we have different, if suppose this is a polygon, and it is divided into multiple polygons, multiple surfaces. Suppose this is the surface number one, S1, this is surface number two, S2, and this is the whole surface number three. And there are multiple surfaces, because if you consider the cube, then in case of cube, there are total eight faces. One, two, three, behind four, this is five, and below is six. So total six surfaces, correct? For example purpose, for understanding purpose, we have taken this particular diagram, and this is nothing but, this has the surface one, surface two, and surface three. So in case of polygon tables, we have to have the tables, series of tables, containing vertices, edges, and surfaces. Means what we have to do? We have to prepare, we have to make three tables. First table is vertice table. A vertice means it is the corner or value of the or point where the edges are meeting. So this is vertice. Then another table is edge table. Edge table is nothing but like an edge. This is edge, this is edge, this is edge. So this is edge, so edge table. Then we have surface table. So this is surface one, surface two, surface three. There may be multiple surfaces available. So we have to prepare three tables. This is a table number one, this is table number two, and this is table number three. The first table is called as vertice table. Second table is edge table. Third table is surface table. So in vertice table, we have to store the vertices or coordinates of the vertices. For example, if you are taking a V1, V1 will have vertices like X1, Y1, and Z1, correct? correct? Z1. So three vertices, x1, y1, z1. Similarly, we will have different vertices for v2, then v3, v4, v5, v6. So here are the v1, v2, v3, v4, v6. As this is a 3D representation, there are three coordinates, x coordinate, y coordinate, and z coordinate. So v1, v2, v3, v4, v5, v6. So in vertice table, after storing the values of the vertices, we have to move towards the edge table. So edge is nothing but the line drawn between the two vertices. So edge E1, it is connecting the vertice V1 and V2. So E1, which are the vertices related to E1? V1 and V2. So in edge table, you have to write edge E1. What is this E1? It is edge E1, which connects the two vertices V1 and V2. Similarly, if you take E2, E2 will connect V1 and V3. So V1 and V3. Similarly, E3, this is E3, which connects V3 and V4, which connects V3 and V4, and E4, it connects V2 and V4. Similarly, you will have E5, E6, E7, and E8. So E8 is also there, so you can add here as a E8, and in case of E8, what are the vertices we have? V4 and V6, V4, V6, V6. So that many vertices are available. So this is nothing but called as edge table. And finally, you must write the surface table. Surface is a bigger quantity than the edge. Edge is a bigger quantity than the vertices. So surface is a combination of, or it is made of from multiple edges. We know that in case of polygon, polygon is a closed figure formed by three or more than three edges. So surface is nothing but also a polygon, which is formed by three or more than three edges. Now here, surface should be closed figure. Remember, surface should be closed figure. So in case of S1, what are the edges? E1, E2, E3, and E4. There are four edges. So we have written S1 is equal to E1, E2, E3, E4. So we have this. Then S2 is equal to, this is S2, E3, E5, E8. Those are the, this is a surface and those are the edges related to that surface. S3, E6, E5, E7. So those are nothing but the three edges having the S3 surface. So we have written the three tables. One is vertice table, edge table, and surface table. This is related to that. So it is nothing but a bigger quantity. Edge table, from edge table, we can write the surface table. So in case of polygon tables, it is nothing but a series of tables. Series. There are different number of tables. Like vertice table, edge table, and surface table. So three tables are required to represent the polygon, to represent table a polygon. Hence, it is called as polygon tables. So this is the first method of representing 3D object. This is the first method. Now we'll discuss another method of representing the 3D object. Another method, this is the second method of representing the polygon or representing the 3D object, that is called as polygon equations. We know that if suppose you are taking a line, this is suppose line, then line can be represented by equation y is equal to mx plus c, right? Mx plus c. So where m is the slope of the line and c is the y-intercept. So similarly, any plane in two dimension or three dimension can be represented by using equation. So this is suppose a plane, then it can be represented by ax plus by, plus cz, plus d is equal to 0. C is equal to 0. So this is nothing but the equation of the plane. So polygon, each polygon, as we know in previous slide, we have different surfaces, surface 1, surface 2, surface 3. Similarly, in this particular diagram, we have first, this is surface, or you can say polygon, this is surface number 2. So each surface can be represented by equation like ax plus by plus cz plus d. For example, if for S1, you can represent the equation as ax1 plus by1 plus cz1 plus d is equal to 0. And for S2, the equation of polygon will become ax2 plus by2 plus cz2 plus d is equal to 0. So both the surfaces will have different equation. And that equation can represent the polygon. This polygon will be represented by one equation. This polygon will be represented by another equation. And there are multiple polygons. This is not necessary to have only two polygons. the polygons will be multiple polygons, and you can represent each polygon by different equation, so this is the second method of representing the polygon. Now I will give another example of the cube. So cube will have how many surfaces? Total six surfaces, right? Will have six surfaces. So each surface will have the separate equation, and whenever you are combining those equations together, you will form the object. So this is nothing but a cube. This object nothing but a cube. Now after combining those, it will prepare object, 3D object. So this is the second method of representing polygon, that is called as the polygon equations. Now we will discuss the third method of object representation, that is called as sweep representation. Now what is the sweep representation? In case of sweep representation, first of all you have to take a 2D object. You have to consider 2D object. Now after taking this 2D object, what you can do, you can use some operation on it, some operation, like you can use translation, translational symmetry, or you can use the rotational symmetry. And by using the translational or rotational symmetry, you can create the 3D object. You can create 3D object. Now how it can be created? For example, if suppose you have circle, and if you are using the translational symmetry, so circle, this circle, then circle, next circle, next circle, translational symmetry, what it will form? It will form a cylinder. It will form a cylinder. So cylinder is a 3D object. In some softwares, it may be in a CAD software, CAD related softwares, you are selecting a 2D object, and by using some sweep representation or sweep symmetry, you are creating a 3D object. For example, I want to create a glass in the software. So what I can do, I can select such type of shape. This is a symmetrical axis, and I will rotate this about the symmetrical axis. I will get a glass, right? I will get glass. So this is nothing but how we can create a 3D object. So here one example is given. Suppose circle we have, and if you use the translational symmetry, translational sweep, then you can create a cylinder. So what is cylinder? This is nothing but a circle. Second, third, there are infinite number of circles, but you are using what? Translational symmetry, translational sweep. So you can create a cylinder. Similarly, if suppose I am taking a circle, and I have suppose one axis, symmetric axis, and if suppose I am rotating this object about this axis, then what I will get? I will get a torus. So such type of value I will get. If suppose this is the circle, and if you rotate about axis, you will get a torus. Torus is nothing but a shape like a tube, or you can say this is a shape of the torus. It is called as torus. So torus can be created by using a rotational sweep, a rotational sweep about an axis, about an axis. So this is nothing but the third method of representing the object, that is called as sweep representation. If suppose I want to create a cube, what I can do? I can take a square, and I can use the translational sweep to create a cube, right? So that cube can be created by using a translational sweep. Similarly, you can create multiple objects where the symmetry can be used, and the object can be created. So in case of sweep representation, always remember we are considering 2D shape or 2D object, and by using translational or rotational symmetry, we can convert into 3D object. So our output is in 3D, input is in 2D, and using some symmetry like a translational or rotational symmetry, we will derive a new object that is a 3D object. So this is called as sweep representation. Now after sweep representation, object representation technique, 3D object representation technique, that is nothing but a constructive solid geometry. So this is the fourth object or 3D object representation technique, that is called as constructive solid geometry. Now in case of constructive solid geometry, what you can do, you have to consider the 3D object, basic 3D object. Which are the basic 3D objects? Like a cube, you have cylinder, you have sphere. So those are the basic objects, basic 3D objects. Then after taking that basic 3D object, you have to apply some operations like union. You can apply union, difference, you can apply intersection. And by applying that operations, you can create a new object, create new 3D object. So that is called as constructive solid geometry. Constructive solid geometry. I will take example. So in case of constructive solid geometry, the input is also 3D. Those are nothing but the basic shapes, and output is also 3D. For example, if you are taking a cube, okay, I will take example of the example. If suppose I have a cube and I am taking a cylinder, if suppose I want to make a hole for the in this cube, okay, so how I can do this? I can take a cylinder and cylinder will be like this, and I can have the difference between this minus that. So what I will get? I will get the cube with the hole. Cube with the hole. So this is nothing but operation called as constructive solid geometry. So here is one example. You can use which type of operations? You have to use set operations like union, you have difference, you have intersection. So this is nothing but what type of operation? It is difference. A cube minus this particular cylinder, by considering the symmetrical axis, you will get the cube with the hole, cylindrical hole in between. So that is nothing but called as constructive solid geometry. So this shape is not available. This is not a basic shape, but those are the basic shapes. Means cube is a basic shape, cylinder is a basic shape, and you are getting the output as a new shape, new different shape. Now here is one example. If suppose I am taking a pyramid, this is a pyramid, okay, pyramid. Then I have a cube and pyramid. And by doing some operations, I can create a new object. If suppose I am having a union operation, union, combination of two, then I will get the new object. So this is nothing but a new object constructed by using CSG method. So which operation we have used? We have used union operation. We have used union operation. And by union operation, I got the new object, which is not a basic shape. Such type of shape is not available. Cube is available, pyramid is available, but such type of shape is not available. So you can create this type of shape by using union operation. Similarly, you can have a difference operation, you can have an intersection operation, and the output is also 3D. So remember, in case of CSG, your input is 3D object, that is a basic 3D object, and after performing the operations, you are getting the output in 3D. Output object is also in 3D. So this is called as constructive solid geometry. Now, after having the discussion of CSG, that is the fourth method of representing 3D object. We have next method, that is the fifth method of representing 3D object, that is called as quad tree. As the word suggests, quad means four, and tree means you have to create a tree-like structure. So in data structure, you have seen the tree. So tree is like such type of structure, right? Such type of structure you are getting in the tree. So in case of quad tree, you have to divide the thing. You have to divide the thing into four parts and prepare a tree. Or prepare a tree-like structure. So that is called as quad tree. Now here is the example. Suppose this is the object, and this object having the field areas here, and in this particular region here and here and here. So how you can draw the tree, or you can say quad tree? So initially you can consider this as a whole object. This is a whole object. This object is divided into four parts. This is the first division, right? This is the first division. After dividing this, is there any region is completely filled with the black color? No, here the combination of black and white, here also the combination of black and white, here is the combination of black and white, but this is the white space, correct? This is the white space. So how you can draw the tree? Initially the object will be taken and you can divide into four parts, like 1, 2, 3, and 4. So it is like 1, 2, 3, and 4. So third is completely white, so no need to divide it again. Now shape, this is the first part, this is the second part, this is the third part, and this is the fourth part. So you must divide the first part, because complete first part is not white, so you can divide it into how many parts? Again into four parts, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So divide into four parts. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And one is completely white, so no need to divide it again. Two is completely white. Four is completely white. So what you have to do? You have to divide this region again. So that is nothing but the third region into four parts. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now in this particular region, this is the first region, which is a combination of black and white. This is combination of black and white, but third region is completely black. So it is 1, 2, 3, and 4. So what you can do, you can represent this with the hash or black. Fourth region is white, no need to divide, but 1 and 2 you must divide. So 1 will be divided again into four equal parts. So 1, this is the first part. First part is filled, so you can fill this first part. In case of second, 1, 2, 3rd part is filled. So you will have third part as a filled one. So third one is this one. So it is hash. So this is nothing but about the first region. Now what about second region? You can use the same basic. You can divide the second region into four parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So third and fourth is should be divided once again. So it is 1, 2, 3, and 4. So again, third, it is not required to divide. Fourth, you can divide it into four parts. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. So fourth one is filled. So for second, we have to divide it again. Now I will show you the, what you can say. I will show you what is the output. So this is the output. First part, it is divided into four equal parts, then again divided into four equal, third is divided into fourth equal parts. So this is filled. Now 1 and 2 is divided. In case of second, we have divided first part, 3 and 4 again, 3 and 4. This is 3, 3 and 4. Again, it is showing what space is there. Again, fourth, it is divided. So accordingly, you will get such type of representation. It is like a tree structure. This is a tree structure. So you can find such type of structure, trees like a structure. So you are dividing the in the form of tree. So it is a root node. This is a root node, and then you are dividing into child node like this. So this is nothing but called as quadtree, and this is one representation of 3D object representation. It represents only 2D, no issue, but it is one more method of representing the object by using. So this is the fifth method of representation of 3D object. Now on the same basis, this is useful for 2D objects. This is a 2D. Now on the same basis, you can have 3D object representation by using such type of tree structure. Using such type of tree structure, that is called as octree. That is called as octree. Now, what is the octree? This is a sixth method of representation. Octree. Oct means what? Oct means 8. Oct means 8. And what is a tree? Tree means you have to prepare a tree-like structure. In case of two dimension, I will show you. Here, it is divided into four parts because it is a two-dimensional. And based on that, we have prepared the tree structure. Now, in case of three dimension, we have to divide into 8 parts. If you divide a cube, how many parts in equal you can divide? If you cut, this is the first cut, okay? And this is the second cut, and this is the third cut. So you will have total 8 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and behind there is an 8 part. You can take an example of lemon. A lemon can be cut into 8 parts, right? And if you take a example of chapati, so chapati can be divided into 4 parts. 4 parts, right? So this is in case of octree. Octree is used to represent the object in a 3D object into the tree-like structure. Now here is the example. This is a cube, and this part is filled with the black color. This is filled with the black color. So we will divide into 8 parts. Now this is the fifth part, which is filled with the black color. So that fifth is shown with the black color. Now all other regions are not, means they are a single color. So no need to divide it again. But regarding the second, this is the second part, right? Second part. So you must divide into total 8 parts. So divided again, and 1, 2. So two second part is filled with the black color. So it is shown. So this is nothing but called as octree representation. This is called as octree representation. Oct means what? 8. Quad means what? 4. Quadtree is used for 2D object. Octree is used for 3D object. So this is called as 3D object representation methods. We'll see fractals afterwards, but this is about all the methods we have discussed one by one. There are many methods we have discussed: polygon tables, polygon equations, sweep representation, constructive geometry, solid geometry, quadtree, octree, and fractals. Fractal we'll discuss separately. So this is all about 3D object representation methods. In case of fractals, fractals means it is uneven, shape, uneven shape. Fractal is used to represent uneven shape, like a mountain, clouds, then tree structure. So fractals are used. So there are different types of fractals. We have self-similar type of fractals, self-affine type of fractals, invariant fractals. So all those fractals will be discussed afterwards. So thank you for joining this particular session.